See, refraction is spherical surface is nothing but beta. When two transparent medium are separated by a spherical surface, two transparent medium means like air and water, or air or kerosene,
okay, sir.
Or any two metals, if they are being separated by a spherical surface, a part of your sphere, then the refraction will be taking place between the incident and as well as of your refracted ray from the other end. Whenever a light is going from one
yes,
surface
sir.
To another surface, there will be a refraction. So what I can say, when two transparent media are being separated by a spherical surface, light incident on the surface will get refracted into the medium on the other side. Like say, for example, if I'm taking the spherical surface, something like this. This is your spherical surface. This one is your principal axis. This is your principal axis. And this is your spherical surface right now. So somewhere, whenever the ray of light has been incident, this is of refractive index mu 1, and this one is refractive index of your mu 2. Okay, now?
Yes, sir.
This is a pole. It is not a mirror beta. It is a part of a spherical surface. It is a part of your
spherical sir.
Articulation. Okay, now?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? Now see, in this one, when two transparent medium are separated by the spherical surface, and whenever a light is been incident on this one, this is the light which has been incident on this one. Okay, in the,
yes,
in the direction of the light, we take the sign convention positive. Opposite direction of light, we'll take it as if a negative.
Negative.
On surface, this is the center of curvature. This is the center of curvature that is nothing but C. The distance from P to C will be equal to what beta? The distance from P to C will be equal to what? Radius of curvature, that will be equal to your capital R. That will be
yes,
your
sir.
Capital R. Somewhere here, there is an object on Kundam right now. Say, for example, this is your object right? Standing in front of this one. So, this is your object O.
Okay. Yes, sir.
The distance from the object to this one. So, object to the pole is known as of your object distance. That is represented by letter U.
Okay.
The distance from P to C is nothing but of your center of curvature. C is nothing but center of curvature. P is a pole. And this is of your air medium. And this is your other surface. For the air medium, we are taking mu 1. In the R else, you take that in the incident direction of light, whatever the refractive index is there, that we always take it as of your mu 1 beta. In the direction of incident of a light, we always take the refractive index as what? Mu 1.
Mu 1.
If the refraction is taking place, that will be taken as of your mu 2. So I hope
yes,
you have the formula for this one. Mu 2 by your V minus of your mu 1 divided by U is equals to your mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by R. This is only the formula which is applicable for solving the numericals for the spherical surface. Mu 2 by V minus of your mu 1 by U is equals to your mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by your capital R part of relation. Is it clear?
Okay. Yes, sir.
What is image? What is the V beta? V is your image distance. V is your image distance right now for me. Okay. U is your
U is the object distance.
Object distance. R is the radius of your curvature part of relation. And what do you call that one? Mu 1 and mu 2 are the refractive.
Refractive indexes.
Okay, now. Now,
yes,
if the spherical surface is, if the spherical surface is made into plane surface, like right here for plane surface, for plane surface. For plane surface. Tell me what will be the radius of curvature for plane surface beta? Infinity together?
Yes, sir.
So if R is equal to infinity in above question, what will be the relation beta will be getting? Mu 2 by your V minus mu 1 by your U is equal to anything divided by infinity will be how much? Zero?
Zero, sir. Yes, sir.
How much I can write here? Mu 2 by your V is equals to mu 1
mu
by
2. Yes, sir. Mu 1 by.
I can write mu 2 by your mu 1 is equals to your V by,
V by U.
So this is also one of the important relation for the plane surface. For the plane surfaces, mu 2 by mu 1 is equals to how much for me? V by your U particle relation.
Yes, sir.
Same way, if I'm writing the magnification for this one. That is your lateral magnification, Anna. Lateral magnification. The other name for this one is nothing but of your transverse magnification. Transverse magnification. Okay. Lateral magnification or your transverse magnification represented by letter of your M. Magnification M will be equal to how much beta? What is the formula? Size of your image divided by size of your
size object. Size of object. Yes, sir.
ideal surface, what you do is you just take the refractive index of the first medium mu one and multiply with your image distance v divided by your mu two into your u. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Magnification m is equals to your mu one by mu two into your v by your u particle relation. This is your magnification basic formula. So m is equals to your mu one by mu two into your by your u.
Clear? So this is the magnification of curved surfaces, spherical surfaces.
Curved surfaces will be multiplying with your refractive indexes for the given condition. Clear?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
What is our basic formula? Mu two by v minus mu one by u is equals to mu two minus mu one by your r. R is the radius of curvature for the plane surface. The radius of curvature is how much? Better for plane surface, r is equals to infinity. So it is mu two by mu one is equals to v by u. For the lateral magnification, if I am writing better, for the lateral magnification, they are transverse magnification represented by letter M. M is equals to your size of image by size of object. R that is equals to your mu one by mu two into your v by your u. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next one and very important. Keep a note for this one here, beta. We generally get confused how to take the mu one and mu two, beta. Make sure that we use mu one for that medium
incident of light.
Yeah, for that medium in which light is incident, or in I can say in which object is placed. And the ray of
yes,
light,
sir.
It means in the direction of your ray, object part.
Object one. Yes, sir.
You always use a mu one for that region or that place wherever object is being placed. That means wherever object is being placed, that will be always be taken as what beta? Mu one. Is it?
Yes, sir. Got it, sir.
The same way, keep a star mark for this one and write. If there are more than two surfaces or more than two media, okay, then what you do is use mu one for that medium. In which object is placed, for first time. Okay.
Sir, means like for first time.
And then side by side, you can go on use. Then side by side, I'll try to tell you with the help of diagram. Okay. Let's see here. If I'm getting a spherical surface like this. This is one spherical surface, and this is your another spherical surface. Got it? And
yes, sir.
Principal axis like this. There is a principal axis like this. Okay, there is a principal axis like this. And this is one more medium here, right? Okay. And there are different number of mediums. Like say, for example, this is your medium one. This is a pole one. This is your another pole, and this one is your another pole. Okay. This is the
yes.
Medium. This is your second medium, and this one is your third medium. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Right. Once again. Like this surface, you take it as of your medium one. This surface you take it as medium two, okay, and this surface, this side, you take it as of your three. Are you there, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Share out on the screen.
Yes, sir. Out on, sir.
Now see, let us try to take the refractive index. First, then the refractive index mu naught is contained. Next, here it is nothing but mu dash. The next one here it is mu double dash, and here it is right now mu triple dash.
Yes.
Isn't it? Now, wherever the object is being kept, right now, say for example, I am keeping the object somewhere here. So this is your object. Object O. Okay. Now, refraction at the surface one jargina pro. Isn't it? So if I'm talking about your refraction at your one, whenever you are using the refraction at your one, mu one will be equal to how much beta?
Mu naught.
And mu two will be equal
mu
to
dash.
Mu dash.
Yes.
Refraction is happening at your second surface.
Refraction.
Okay, like this. Second surface. At a time, mu 1 will become for me mu dash.
Mu dash.
Mu 2 will become for me mu double.
Mu double dash.
The same way, if I'm talking about your refraction at your third surface, then at a time, mu 1 will become how much for me, beta? Mu double dash. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Mu 2 will become how much for me? Mu 2 will be equal to mu 3.
Mu triple dash.
What an idea.
Got it, sir.
Isn't it? So that is the way, how do we take the sign conventions for the spherical surfaces? Mu 2 by mu 1 by minus mu 1 mu. Mu 1 by u is equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by r. Lateral transverse or transverse magnification, m is equals to size of image by size of object. It is equals to mu 1 by mu 2 into v by u. And use the mu 1 for that medium in which object is being placed. So use the mu 1 for that medium in which object is being placed. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Let us try to do one numerical based on this one. See this question. So if I'm asking the question, locate the image. Locate the image of the point object. Of the point object O. Point object O. The point C. The point C is center of curvature. Is center of curvature, center of curvature of the spherical surface, of the spherical surface. Okay, this is your spherical surface, this is your object given like this. Okay,
yes,
somewhere is your object O and this is your pole P. And this is the center of curvature. Here it is mu 1 beta. Mu 1 for air, I'm taking it as 1. And yes. I'm taking it as like water. That is 4 by 3.
4 by 3.
It is filled with the water. This part is been filled with the water.
Okay, sir.
This side is been filled with the water. Okay. Now let us try to apply the sign convention. Object distance is given for me in the problem beta. From O to P, the object distance is given as of your 20 centimeter. The distance from your pole to the center of curvature is given for me as of your 40 centimeters. Okay, this is the data given for us. Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now tell me what is the sign convention? All the values. Mu 1 is how much?
1, sir.
Mu 2 is how much?
4 by 3, sir.
Object distance is how much?
Sir, u is 20 and v is
direction of ray of light is from O to P. You are measuring the distance from P to O. That means minus 20.
Okay, yeah. Yes, sir. Minus.
Important. Then radius of curvature, capital R, in the direction of light gravity, that will be your plus
40
centimeter.
Four. Okay.
Yes. This is the formula. We are going from which medium, which to which medium? Rarer medium to denser medium. So
yes.
This one is mu 2 by v minus of your mu 1 by your u is equals to your mu 2 minus mu 1 divided
by r.
This is for what medium, beta? When you are going from rarer medium to denser medium.
Okay, sir.
From denser medium to rarer medium, just change the subscripts, beta. In the place of 2, you keep the 1 and simplify the problem. That's it.
Okay, sir. So then it will become mu 1 by v minus mu 2 by u.
Mu 2 by u is equals to mu 1 minus mu 2 divided by r.
Okay, sir.
Now, mu 2 value substitute here. So, this will be equal to 4 by 3. Image distance, we don't know. We need to calculate it. Minus mu 1 is equals to 1 divided by u. U is equals to minus 20. And that is equals to mu 2 minus mu 1. That is your 4 by 3 minus 1 divided by radius of curvature. That will be equal to your 40. Isn't it? So, this
yes.
is equal to how much for me? 4 by over 3v minus minus a plus. That is equals to 1 by 20. Equals to 4 by 3 minus 1 will be equal to how much, beta? 4 by 3 minus 1 is
3 by
1 by 3, yeah?
1 by, yes, sir, 1, no.
So, it is 1 by 3 into 40. 3, 4,
yes, sir.
12. That means it will be equal to 120.
Yes, sir.
Antena? So, now
yes.
value of 4 by 3V outside. So, 4 by 3V is equal. So, this will become for me 1 by 20 minus 1 by 20.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So 1 by 120 minus 1 by 20. So take the
yes.
LCM with this one. So if I'm simplifying the LCM with this one, this will be equal to how much here? It is 120. The next one is nothing but how much?
Sir, it is 1 minus 60, sir.
6 kada? So this yes. V go there right now. So V will be equal to how much beta? V will be equal to
40 into 4, 160 by minus.
Divided by this one is how much here? 5. So this will
5,
be.
It's coming.
4 for the 16 gravity, it is minus of 160 divided by 5. So finally, how much I'll be getting beta? 5 ones are, 5 threes are 15. So V is equals to minus 5 threes are 15. 1 will be remain right now. 5 twos are 10. That means it will be minus 32 centimeter. V is
okay, sir.
Minus of your 32 centimeters. Minus
yes, sir.
Is what beta? The image is formed
against the light, sir.
Left of the spherical surface.
In mu. Yes, sir. Virtual. In mu 1.
Yeah, and it will be your virtual perpendicular. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So, image is right now, V represents me. It is your virtual because it is on the same side. Robert.
Yes.
Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, I hope you got an idea how to use the sign convention for this one.
Yes, sir.
Sure. Let's try to go for one more numerical. Same question, but again, look at the image and height of its image. Locate the image and also find its height. And find its height. Okay.
Yes.
Diagram for us. Okay. Here it is of the mirror. There is nothing but P. And here there is an object in front of this one like this. This is the center of curvature C. Center of curvature nunchi ikkada varaku ee distance vachesi 20 centimeters nana. Object distance from the pole is given for me as of your 40 centimeters. Okay.
Oh.
1 is equals to 1 and mu 2 is equals to 4 by 3. Ante na?
Yes.
So I have given already the condition and the height of this one is, say, for example, 1 centimeter.
Yes, sir.
Now first calculate the image beta. Find the image part. First tell me what are the data right now for this one.
Sir, mu 1 is 1. Mu 2 is 4 by 3, R is 20.
Yeah, R is equals to, and U is equals to. The.
Sir, R is equals to 20 centimeters.
Sign convention, beta.
Sorry, minus 20, minus away from here.
So this is your minus 20 centimeters, and this one
minus
is
40.
Minus 40 centimeters.
Yes.
We need to calculate what is the image, isn't it?
Yes.
Again, you're going from which medium to which medium, rarer medium to denser.
Rarer to denser.
So this will
mu 2 by V.
Mu 2 by your V minus of
mu 1 by
U is equals to your mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by your radius of curvature. That is nothing but your capital R.
Yes.
Now substitute the values there better. Mu 2 value is how much for me? 4 by 3 by your image we need to calculate minus mu 1 is how much for me?
1
divided by object distance is minus 40. That is equals to 4 by 3 minus 1 divided by minus 20. And then
yes.
So now this will become for me how much beta? 4 by 3 into V. 4 by 3 into V will
yes,
be,
sir.
This one will be
plus 1 by 4.
40. That is equals to 4 by 3 minus 1 is how much beta?
1 by 3.
Hmm?
1 by 3.
1 by 3. 1 by 3 and time to 1
by 3. 3 will go down and time.
4 by 3 minus 1. And the?
Sir, 4 by 3 minus 1 is 1 by 3, sir.
1 by 3. 1 by 3 into 20, gada.
Yes, sir. Minus 60.
Minus 60. Ante gada.
1 by minus 60.
1 by 60. Ante na?
Yes.
4 by your 3V will be equal to minus of 1 by 60. This plus either if I take here side, this will become
minus 1 by
40.
What yes.
is the maximum of this one, beta? 120.
Yes.
So 120 means this will go how many times? Two times. So it is minus 2. This is minus 4, 3. This will be 3. That means this will be equal to how much beta? Minus 2 minus 3 is how much?
Minus 5, sir.
Minus 5 divided by 120. This is your 4 by your 3V.
Yes.
Isn't it? So minus 5 by 12 is 120 is how much beta? So it is 4 divided by 3 into V is equals to 5 1s are 5, 2 is 10, 2 will be going 5 4s are, and then minus 1 by 24.
Yes, sir.
And then 5 1s are 5, 2 is 10, 2 will be left out, 5 4s are 20.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So what will be the value of your V we need to calculate, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Both na jodo. How many times it will go in 24? 3, 3 into 24.
8, both? Sir.
So how many times this will be?
8, sir. 3 ones are 3.
How much?
8, sir, sir.
8, sir. So 8 it will go here right now. So what will be the V? So V will be equal to 4 8, sir.
24, sir.
Huh?
32, sir.
32. 32 centimeters.
Minus 32. Yes, sir. This is also virtual image.
Yeah, this is also your virtual image. Minus sign logic.
Yes.
Magnification formula, beta.
Sir, mu to V by mu 1 u.
Will be equal to your how much, beta? Mu 1 into V divided.
Sorry, mu 1 into V. Yes.
Into your u. Magnification means I can write in terms of height of your image divided by height of your object is equals to mu 1 by mu 2 into your V by U. There, huh?
Yes, sir.
What we need to calculate? Height of image. So height of your image will be equal to your mu 1 by your mu 2 into your V by your U into height of your object. Substitute the values. Mu 1 value is nothing but how much beta? Air value got, that value was equal to how much for mu 1?
1.
By, this one was
4 by 3. 3 will go up.
Into yes. V, how much we got? Just now we got the V value. V value is minus
30. Minus 32.
So this will be minus 32 by object distance is how much for me beta? Minus?
Minus 20, sir. No, so minus 40, sir.
Minus 40, sir. This will be minus of your 40.
Yes, sir.
Minus 40. Okay, so
yeah.
This will become how much for me? 3 by 4 into this one is minus 32 divided by 40. And then,
yes, sir. 4 8s are, 8s are, and 10s are.
4 8s are, how much? 4 8s are 32. And then,
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So again, it will go in how much beta?
Again. 8 1s are and 8 5s are.
8 1s are, 8
5s are.
That means 3 by 5.
3 by 5.
So yes. 3 by 5 means how much I'll be getting? 3 by 5. 3 by 5 means? Understand?
Yes, sir. 0.6, sir. 6.
Sandra?
Yes, sir.
Anderson?
0.6, sir.
Jura?
Yes, sir.
This will be 0.6. Isn't it?
So yes.
Image is how much I'm getting? Positive or negative? Sign convention, ni kattai pe negada.
Yes, sir.
This one, everyone has been getting cancelled there. So, height of your image is equals to your plus of your 0.6.
Yes.
Meters. As the height of the image we got positive, that means it is above the principal axis. So obviously, yes. Image is what? The image is erect. The image is erect.
Yes, sir.
The principal axis, then only it will be negative. Otherwise, it will be your positive part of the image.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, got it?
Yes, sir.
Sorry, it was the basic question. See this question right here. Say for example, a mark on the surface of sphere in the bracket mu is equals to 3 by 2 is waved is weaved from a diametrically opposite position. Diametrically opposite position. It appears to be at a distance of 15 centimeter from its actual position. Find the radius of sphere. Mark on the surface of the sphere is being weaved from a diametrically opposite position. It appears to be at a distance of 15 centimeter from its actual position. Find the radius of your sphere perfilation. So this is your sphere beta. Okay.
Yes.
This is your diameter. Okay. And somewhere here there is an object. This is your object O. Okay.
Yes.
Even ray of light is going from this one beta. That is not an object. No? So where is the object you see? A mark on the surface of the sphere is weaved from diametrically opposite position. Mark on the surface of the sphere is telling. That means on the surface of sphere means somewhere here. So this is your object.
And yes, sir.
On the other end, that means I'm standing somewhere here and I'm seeing this situation. That means I'm weaving from the diametrically opposite side. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Diametrically from the opposite sides. That means ray of light is going from this object like this up to here.
Yes, sir. Then it'll refract.
No. That means the ray of light is going from which medium beta? It is going from the...
Sir, it's already a sphere, so...
Denser to rarer. Denser together because object is going from the sphere to outside.
Outside, yes.
Because it is diametrically on opposite corner right now. It is diametrically on the opposite
corner.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So that means object is in which medium? Denser medium. Denser medium and this one is your rarer medium.
Rarer medium.
Now, how do you draw the center of curvature, beta? Center of curvature should always be taken from where, beta? Radius of curvature, normal. Normal.
Yes, sir.
Draw just quantity. This will give me the normal right now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that will be the normal. Whenever you are drawing the normal, make sure of that one. That is the way. How do we draw the normal? Normal
okay,
pass through the center of curvature. Now tell me, when a ray of light is going from denser medium to rarer medium, what happens to the refracted ray?
It'll move away from the normal.
Away from the normal, so slightly it will move away like this.
Yes, sir.
It will move slightly in the this direction. Actually, like a point, it should have been gone in a straight line.
Yes, sir.
With the refraction, it is going in this direction. That means if I extend this one in the backward direction for me, the image formation is somewhere here.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? That is the image form. Because when I'm seeing it,
we see farther.
As if the image has been forming on the other side.
So yes.
This is the pole of the mirror. And refraction is happening at this surface. Brother. So this is your...
Yes.
Isn't it? And where is the object right now? What is the given condition? A mark on the surface of the sphere of refractive index. Then your refractive index is given as of your... 4 by 3. Refractive index of that one is given as 4 by 3. That means mu is equals to, for this one, it is 4 by 3. And this is air gravity that will be equal to 1 rare medium gravity. It appears to be at a distance of 15 centimeter from the actual position. That means in the diagram, in the question itself, we told that image is formed at a distance of your 15 centimeter from the actual position of the object. That is what he has given in the problem. Antena?
Yes.
It appears to be at a distance of 15 centimeter from its actual position. Find the radius of the sphere. Now you tell me what will be the mu 1 and mu 2 first.
Sir, so mu 1 would be 4 by 3, sir, here.
Yeah. Refractive index is 4 by 3 HR, problem?
3 by 2 HR, sir. So it is glass.
3 by 2. 3/2. So mu 1 will be equal to 3/2.
Yes, sir.
Why? Because object is being present in that medium property. So mu 1 will be mu 3/2, and mu 1 will be equal to how much beta? 1. What will be the object distance beta from the
sir, mu 2 is 1, right? Mu 2 is 1, right?
This is mu 2. Mu 2 is 1. What is object distance beta from the P? O to P distance will be equal to how much?
Sir, O to P is the diameter, sir.
The surface. So this will be the object distance. U will be equal to how much? Radius of the sphere R?
Yes, sir.
So that means object distance will be equal to diameter, gada?
Yes, sir.
So U will be equal to how much for me? Minus of
2. Minus 2.
The ray of light is going from O to P. You are measuring the distance from P to O.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So P to O will be equal to minus of your 2 into R. Now tell me, where is the image formed? Image is formed at what distance? Can you tell me?
15 centimeters.
It's also formed away from the, in the direction opposite of the, this will be no doubt negative.
Minus.
Isn't it? Now tell me, what will be distance from your I to P?
Sir, minus 15 plus 2. Minus 15.
It is right now. Minus R. 2 outside right now. So it is 2R plus of your 15. Can I write like this?
Yes, sir. We can do that.
I have taken the minus common there.
Right? Minus common, yes.
Okay. Now tell me, what will be the radius of curvature? Will it be the positive or negative? The distance will be, radius of curvature will be from where to where beta? Can you tell me? This is the radius.
C to P. Yes, sir. C to P.
So you are measuring the distance from your P to C or C to P?
P to C we have to measure, sir. So minus.
Opposite to the light direction, gather?
Minus R.
So this will be equal to how much for me? Minus of your R. Is the sign convention clear?
Yes, sir.
Now everything is okay with that one. Then you just apply the formula right now. What is the relation I'll be using
now
right
now? Now we have to take mu 1 by V minus mu 2 by
V. Even if I am not using that one, I already took the sign conventions everywhere.
Okay, sir.
The subscripts there. Mu 1 I have took 3/2 and mu 2 I have taken as of 1. So I need not again change the formula. Directly I can use the formula beta here. Mu 2 by your V minus of your, this one is mu 1 by your U is equals to your mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by R. Why I am not changing the formula? Because I already took the value of your mu 1 and mu 2 have interchanged there. Hello?
Sir, but means like we have not interchanged anything, right?
What beta?
Ante we have not interchanged anything, right? And did answer?
No. See, in the...
Okay, like that, sir. Right. Okay, got that.
Same conventions, isn't it?
Yes.
Otherwise, I would have been taken
okay, for... Okay. Like, or else we have to keep it like mu 1 and mu 2 ante a path are, ante mu 1 is equals to 1 and mu 2 is equals to 3/2. Like that, if we take, we have to
change the subscripts right now, isn't it? But here, diagram itself I have taken right now, so need not change again the sign convention. So directly I'm using the formula mu 2 by V minus mu 1 by U is equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by your R. Now just write the values for that one. So it is mu 2 value is how much beta? 1. So it is your 1 divided by V value is how much for me?
Minus 2 plus 15.
Your 15 minus mu 1 value is how much for me? 3/2 into U value is how much for me? Minus of your 2R. So that will be equal to mu 2 minus mu 1. That is 1 minus of 3/2 divided by this one is minus R.
Yes.
So just simplify that one. This one is minus of 2 into R plus 15. Minus of minus, this will become for me plus. So this will become for me 3/2 into 2, 4. This will become 4R. Antena?
Yes.
It will be equal to 1 minus 3/2 is how much?
Sir, minus. Sir, minus 1 by 3.
Minus 1 by 2. And radius is also.
Sorry, minus 1 by 2.
This minus will get cancelled.
Yes.
So
yes,
sir. How much right now for me? 1 by this one is minus of 2R plus of your 15 is equals to 1 by this one is right now 2R plus will become for me minus of 3/4 into your R.
Yes, sir.
Then
4R, yes, sir. 4R is common. So
1 by 2R minus 3/4R and thus into.
Sir, we'll get minus, 1 by minus 6 by 4R. Ante minus 5 by 4R.
What do you mean, sir? This is 1 by, this is minus 2R plus of your 15. That will be equal to
how? Sorry. 2, 3 or 6. Yes, sir, we'll get minus 5 by 4R.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, sorry. It is 1 into 2, right, sir? So 2 minus 3, 1 by 4 r, sir. My, minus 1 by 4.
Minus 1 by 4 r.
Yes.
This minus sign will get cancelled.
Yes, sir.
So I can write here right now. This
4 r is equals to?
Be equal to 2 r.
2 r plus 50. Yes, sir.
So 2 r,
2 r will come this side.
This will become how much for me?
2 r is equals to 15, sir. So r is equals to 15 by 2.
Equal to your how much? 15 by 2. 15 by
7.5.
It will be 7.5 centimeters. So radius of curvature will be 7.5. Diameter will be equal to 2 times of r. That is 2
15, sir.
7.5. So diameter will be equal to 15 centimeters. If he is asking, otherwise it's fine.
Okay, sir.
I hope you got an idea how to do such type of a problem.
Yes, sir.
For the spherical surfaces, make sure of your sign conventions, then you can do the remaining calculations very easily.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So this question you try to tell me and give me the answer. A small object is stuck on the surface of a glass. Surface of a glass sphere. In the bracket, you write refractive index of glass is 3 by 2. Okay, here previously we took 3 by 2 together. I'll take here.
Yes, sir. Glasses.
Well, the same important. So refractive index is 4 by 3. For example, small object stuck on the surface of a glass sphere whose refractive index is how much for me? 4 by 3. And is weaved from the diametrically opposite position on surface. Find transverse magnification. Okay.
Yes.
Transverse magnification. Okay.
Yes.
This is the center of curvature of this CM. Okay. Object has been struck on opposite side. You need to do better. I'll give you 5 minutes of a time. You try to do it out. Isn't
okay.
It? Everything has been given for you, isn't it? So right now, the distance from the center of curvature to this position will always be equal to how much beta? Radius of curvature. That will be capital R. This will be the pole. So P to C also will be equal to how much distance right now?
For
a small object is stuck on the surface of a glass sphere, is being weaved from diametrically opposite position. Find the transverse magnification. Transverse magnification ante deeni yokka refractive index ichadu meeku mu is equal to how much he has given? 4 by 3.
4 by 3.
And here it will be equal to how much for me?
1.
We need to first, what is the transverse magnification formula you tell me?
Sir, mu 1 into v by mu 2 into u.
Mu 1 by your mu 2 into your v by your u.
Yes.
Isn't it? You know the object distance better? U value is how much from the pole? Because refraction is happening at this
minus 2 r.
Minus 2 r. So
yes,
you know
sir.
Distance, you know mu 1, mu 2. What will be mu 1 beta?
Sir, mu 1 is 4 by 3.
Very good. Mu 1 is 4 by 3. Mu 2 will be equal to 1.
1.
Object distance will be equal to minus.
Minus.
So image will be equal to how much? So you find out the image, then you tell me the magnification. Will you do that one?
Yes, sir.
So let's come back. Thank you.
Sir, here R is also like unknown, right, sir? So we also will get it in terms of R only, right, sir? అయిపోయింది సార్, ఒక్క నిమిషం. సార్ దిస్ బట్ టిల్ హియర్ ఐ గాట్ సార్, ఐమ్ స్టిల్ డూయింగ్ సార్. 1/v ప్లస్ 2/3r ఇస్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు -1/3r.
సైన్ కన్వెన్షన్ థర్డ్ క్వశ్చన్ అని.
ఒక్క నిమిషం సార్, ఇది ఒక r ఒకటి మైనస్ మైనస్ తీసుకోవాలి.
Is equals to mu 2 minus mu 1 divided by your r.
Sir, sir, it's actually 1/v plus 2/3r is equals to 1/3r, sir, not minus 1/3.
Yeah. So mu 2 value is how much for me? 1. 1 by v value we need to calculate. It is v minus mu 1 is how much for me? 4/3. Do your r.
This minus 2r. Minus 2r.
Minus of 2r.
Yes.
Mu 2 minus mu 1, so it is 1 minus of 4/3.
Yes, sir.
R value is how much? Radius of curvature positive.
R, sir.
Minus R.
Minus R, yes.
Isn't it? So this will become for me 1/v minus minus a plus. This will become for me 4 by. This will become how much for me, beta?
Sir, it will become minus 6R, sir. That's why plus.
Plus, sir. Isn't it?
So, 4/1.
2, yeah. So this is 2 and this one is 3.
3.
So it is 1 minus 4/3 is how much?
Sir, it will come as -1/-r.
So minus
so minus minus cancel.
1/3r.
Yes, sir. Akkada varaku vachindi, sir. I have to still continue. Shall I continue, sir? Just 1 minute.
1/v is equals to idu entha avutundi ikkada 1/3r.
3r.
So here right now, so this will be 2/3r.
Yes, sir.
So now tell me the LCM for this one. 1/v is equals to
-1/3r.
So it is 1 minus 2. That will be equal to minus 1.
Yes, sir. -1/3.
1 divided by 3r.
Yes, sir.
So v will be equal to how much for me, beta? Minus of your 3r.
3r. Yes, sir.
Image is equal to minus.
Virtual image, sir.
Yeah. Now what do we need to get? Magnification. Magnification formula. M is equal to how much for me? Mu 1.
Mu 1 ante 4/3.
Your v by u.
Yes.
Mu 1 value, how much we got already?
Sir, we can write it as 4/3 directly, sir.
4/3.
And mu 2 is
1. V value is how much?
Minus v is minus 3.
Divided by object distance.
Minus 2r.
Minus of 2r. So this minus.
Minus minus cancel.
R and r also we get cancel. So
4/3 into 3/2.
4/3 into 3/2. That is 2.
3, 3 cancel.
3 and 3 will get cancel.
2, sir.
It will be equal to 2. So magnification, I'm getting it as of your EM is equals to your 2. So that will be the magnification.
Yes. Yes.
All the spherical surfaces are like this only.
Okay, sir.
All the spherical surfaces are like this only. So you need to just take care of your sign conventions and the problems part of it. Okay, na? I'll send you
okay, sir.
Conditions related to this one. Then we can do the numericals related to this given condition. Clear up?
Yes, sir.
Time on the other?
Yes, sir.
So, next one start is going to let us try to go for your lenses. What exactly is a lens, beta? Lens is nothing but a thin transparent material which is bonded by two spherical surfaces. But till now, we have taken one spherical surface rather like this. We have taken one spherical surfaces like this right now. Isn't it? This is one spherical surface. If I take the two spherical surfaces like this and attach it, like say this question and this question, you attach it, beta. What happens? It will form a two combination of the two.
Yes. Yes.
isn't it? So I can say that a thin lens is what? A transparent material which has been bonded by two surfaces.
Two surfaces, two spherical.
It will be a spherical of, and refractive index of that material is different from that of your surroundings. And the refractive index of that material should be obviously different from the remaining part of relation. Okay, like this, say, how do you draw this diagram? Yeah. So like say, for example, first one, if I'm taking the lens, this is something like this. It will like this.
Yes.
Isn't it? So the radius of curvature on the first side is right now, say, for example, R1, and this will be equal to your R2.
Yes, sir.
If both of them are same beta, both of them are same right now, like say, for example, if radius of curvature, okay, and if this is the radius of curvature here, this one is R and this one is R. See here, two spherical surfaces are there now, beta? Isn't it? Two spherical surfaces?
Yes, sir.
So the thin lens is a transparent material which has been bonded by two spherical surfaces. This is one spherical surface, this is one spherical surface. Wasn't it?
Yes, sir.
Now, if the radius of curvature on both these sides, like say for the lens, the central part is very thick. You see it? Central part is very thick compared to the parts which have been at the other end.
Yes.
The middle part is very, very thick. And at the ends, you see, it is very thin.
Yes, sir.
This lens is very, very thin. Isn't it? And this one is very, very thick. Isn't it? For the lens, yes. So like say if I close your eyes and give you the lenses in your hand, can you identify the lens which is a convex and which is a convex? If the central part is very thick, that will be the convex lens.
Okay, sir.
Okay, if the central part is very thin, that will be the concave lens.
Concave, okay.
Sir. Even without, yes, you can identify and tell me which is a convex and which is a concave.
Yes,
you
sir.
Your hand and you, by the guess, if the central part is coming out to be very thicker and the ends are very thin, then you will identify it as what?
Convex.
So, if radius of curvature on both the sides are different, this is known as of your biconvex lens. Okay, if radius of curvature on both the sides are same, it is known as of your equiconvex lens. It is known as what? Equiconvex lens.
Sir, so that biconvex lens is basically concave, right, sir?
Bi?
Ante, ipuda first diagram, it is thin, right, sir?
Convex only. I'll tell you about concave.
Okay, both sir.
Convex only, but only thing is if radius of curvature are slightly different.
Okay, sir.
Biconvex. If the both the radius of curvature are same, it is known as equiconvex.
Yes.
Okay, na. Let's see one more. If I'm taking right now, yeah, like this. Here, one plane. If one surface is plane, beta. Another one is right now. For the plane surface, radius of curvature is infinity, and this is a curved surface R. If this is something like this, then it is known as plano-convex lens. Okay? One surface is plane. This one is your plane surface. And this one is what? A curved surface. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Chalo. With hand on the like this. Okay. This one is your R1 and here it is your R2. This is known as of your concavo convex lens. Okay.
Yes.
So two surfaces are curved and they are in the same direction. Both the curved surfaces, center of curvature in the same direction. Such type of a lens is known as of your concavo-convex lens. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
What is a lens, beta? A thin lens is a transparent material which has been bonded by
two spherical
surfaces. And it is or not, which you do, it should be what? Spherical. Or another.
Okay, sir.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
The refractive index of the lens is always greater than the surrounding beta. refractive index of the lens
yes,
is greater than the surrounding, then it will be your convex. If the refractive index of middle of a lens is greater than that of the surrounding, you always write that one as refractive index of lens is greater than refractive index of your medium.
Okay, sir.
So what is a thin lens?
Sir, so it's like denser medium to rarer medium.
Denser medium to rarer medium.
Yes.
Okay. A thin lens is what? A thin lens is a transparent material bonded by two surfaces, at least one of which should be spherical, at least one of them should be spherical. One of them should be spherical. Is it clear?
Yes.
And the refractive index of the medium should also be the different part of it. Okay. The lens is at the thing. If I say that the lens is thick in the middle, and thin at ends. Then it will be what type of lens, beta?
Thick in the middle means convex.
Yeah, converging lens. Always be what? A converging lens.
Yes.
So the lens is thick in middle and thin at the end. So that will be what type of lens?
Converging.
Converging lens part of relation. I hope you got it.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
If I'm going for the next one. If the lens is thin in the middle and thick at the ends, then it will be what?
Concave.
Concave, isn't it? So I can write here right now. If the lens thin in the middle, if it is thin in the middle and thick at the ends, will behave as what, beta? Will behave as diverging lens.
Yes, sir.
Diverging lens means what type of
lens? Concave, sir.
So this will be your concave lens. Okay. Lens
yes,
is
sir.
In the middle and thick at the ends. It will be what? A concave lens, or it will be your diverging lens. Okay.
Yes.
So let me draw the diagram for this one. Like this. Okay, na? This is your R1.
Yes.
This one is your R1. Or else if I can still take like this.
Sir, in this also types are there, sir.
In this one also types are there. Like this.
Very thin, sir.
Yeah. So if it is R1 and it is, or sorry, it is R. And this one is also your R. Okay. And again, here this is a plane surface. This is like this. And this is curved right now. I have cut this one into exactly from the center.
Yes, sir.
This is R, and the plane surface radius of curvature will be infinity.
Plane or convex.
Yeah. So then this one is like this. This
yes,
one, R1, and this one will be your R. Okay, na? So first one is what? Biconcave.
Yes, sir.
So this one will be
equiconcave.
Next one is nothing but what?
Plano.
Concave.
Yes, sir.
The fourth one is. What the name we have given, beta? So in the convex, we have the first pronunciation is coming concave, then convex.
Now so here convex.
The first pronunciation will come for me, convex.
Convex or concave.
Concave. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Just opposite.
Yes, sir.
Like when we are doing in the convex, the first name is coming what? The opposite of that one. Then it is concave,
yes.
Convex. Now for this one, it is convex or concave. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So that was about your sign conventions related to your lenses part of relations. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So if the lenses are, if the radius of curvature on both the sides are same, that is known as what? Equiconvex lens. Equiconvex lens per definition. Okay, now sign convention
yes.
Same as that of your mirrors, beta. In the direction of light, we take it as positive.
Opposite
direction of a light, we'll be taking it as of your negative.
Negative.
But for the lens, we have two focals, beta. One is on the left axis, another one is on the right axis.
Right axis.
The point O, the center of this one, O is known as what, beta? Optical center. The center of this lenses is known as what?
Optical center.
You just write some terms related to this one, beta. So just keep a note right now. Terms used in lenses. Terms used in your lenses. Okay. First one, Jordan. If I'm taking this one as a field lens like this, and this one is your principal axis, like this. Okay, and this is the center of curvature. The inco center of curvature and the inco center of curvature. Understand that?
Yes, sir.
Of two part of the spheres, like if I extend.
Yes, sir. For one sphere, if you have one, then the for other one you have one more. So
one ray of light which is passing through center. This is center is nothing but your optical center. Whenever a
yes.
ray of light is been passing through the optical center, with whatever the ray of light it has been incident, with the same ray of light, it will be coming back. So
yes.
it will go undeviatedly in the same direction. It will go undeviatedly in the same direction. Okay, no?
Yes.
Even for the concave, it is same beta. This is your concave lens right now. This is your optical center. That is nothing but of your point O. And here there will be the center of curvature, beta. Here this will be right now C1. And here this will be equal to your right now for me, C2. Okay, now? So whenever
yes.
light is been passing through this one like this, they will without deviation, it will be going into it. Clear?
Yes, sir.
That was about the optical center. Optical center is nothing but what, beta? Optical center is nothing but O is the point through which the ray of light will pass. That is known as of your optical center. So O is known as of your optical center. Okay, now? What do you mean by
yes.
what? This is beta. C1, C2 is known as the line which has been joining through the two optical centers. It is known as of your principal axis. Okay, C1 and C2.
Yes.
Isn't it? And it is perpendicular to the lens. Principal axis is perpendicular to the lens. Ante kada?
Yes, sir.
This is vertical and that is C1, C2 is a horizontal line. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Next one, very important term, that is your principal focus. For a lens, we have two principal focus beta. Let's see, if this is your lens you are taking, you can need two radius of curvature alone take up. We'll be having one focus right now here. That is nothing but of your F1. The ray of light is going from the first principal axis beta like this. Whenever it has been incident like this. Whenever it has been incident like this. And whenever it has been incident like this from the focus. Then after passing through the lens, so this is the aperture.
Yes, sir.
Then it will go parallel to the principal axis. It will go parallel to the principal axis like this. Okay.
Yes, sir.
The distance from this focus to the optical center O, to the optical center O, is known as of your focal length. That is nothing but of your F. Okay?
Yes, sir.
In the same way, if I take the lens like this also, and this is your principal axis, if the ray of lights are coming parallel to the principal axis like this, if the ray of light is coming parallel to the principal axis like this, and this is your optical center. This is your optical center. What happens in this one, you tell me? After refraction, it will try to meet at one point.
Yes.
Isn't it? So this will be the another focus that will be equal to how much for me? F2.
Yes. So that time you sent one video, right, sir, of convex and concave lenses.
So
converging
equal to your F2. Yeah. Okay. So
yes,
two focuses. So if the ray of light is coming from the focus, it will go parallel. If a ray of light is coming parallel, it will be made to incident on the focus on the other side. So we have two focal lengths for this one, that is F1 and as well as of your F2.
Yes,
for your concave lens also, beta. The same thing is for your concave lens. Like say if I'm taking about your concave lens like this. This is your optical center. Okay, whenever a ray of light has been coming right now like this, this is your aperture then, isn't it? So whenever a ray of light has been incident from the very far region like this, isn't it?
Then yes, sir.
In the absence of this medium, this should have been met somewhere here, right? This should have been your focus of your F1. But whilst it is entering from one denser medium to another denser medium part, so it will try to get refract. So it will go like this. And this will go like this. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? And this distance from focus to this point, this will be known as of your focal length. That is nothing but F1. Okay?
Yes, sir.
That means the object is somewhere at the focus now. We need to assume that if the object is at the focus, the images will be formed at the infinity because the ray of light will go parallel to that part. Okay?
Yes.
Deen Japo, you try to tell me this one. If this is your concave lens like this, and this is your principal axis, and this is your focus right now, say for example, if you're F. Okay. If a ray of light is coming exactly parallel to the principal axis like this, you know that whenever it has been entering from rarer medium to your denser medium, what happens? It gets refract like this. And
yes,
this will get refract like this. If I extend this one in the backward direction,
they'll meet in the focus.
They'll be meeting at the focus. Okay. So from this focus, this will be F2. From here to this optical center will be equal to second focal length. That will be equal to your F2. Clear?
Yes, sir.
This one is for what type of a lens? This one is your concave and this one is your convex. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, if I say that, if the focal lengths on the both sides are same, if F1 is equal to F2, F1 is equal to F2 means what? If media is same on both sides, if media on both sides of a lens are same, then only the focal length will be same. Okay, na? If
yes,
F1 is not equal to F2, then media on the lens are different.
Yes.
Then media on both sides are different.
Yes, sir.
Okay. If they are equal, that means medium on the both sides is same. If they are not same, means what? If the medium on the both sides are different, that means the focal length of the lens is positive and that of your concave lens it will be your negative. Hence, focal length F means what, beta? Focal length of your F2 any other. Whenever,
yes,
isn't it? So I can write that point here right now. Just keep a star mark and write. The focal length of the convex lens. The focal length of a convex lens. Of a convex lens is what? Positive. Is positive. And that of concave lens. That of your concave lens. That of your concave lens is negative. Concave lens is negative. So your focal length F means what, beta? Here, focal length F means focal length F2. Focal length F2. So we'll be considering F2 into the consideration. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So whenever we are considering the focal length F, F means right now for me F2. And the focal length for the convex lens is positive and for concave lens it is nothing but of your negative. Is it clear? So this was your introduction related to your lenses part of relations. If the medium on both the sides are same, then focal length will be the equal. And if the medium on the both the sides are different, then it will be your what? Medium will be on both the sides will be your different.
Yes, sir.
We'll try to do the numericals in the tomorrow section of the class, or in evening if it is possible, you come to the class bed at 5:30.
Okay, sir. I'll message you by 5 o'clock, sir.
Yes, sir. Number of numericals.
Yes, sir.
Evening 5:30 to 6:30, you come at any cost. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Take care, beta. Bye.
Sir, tomorrow morning also possible, sir?
Yeah, tomorrow morning also we can take it.
Okay, sir.
It's possible.
Send it to it, sir.
Current electricity part, if you need, I can do it out that part.
Okay, sir.
No, if electricity is out, and with that part, we can do it out.
Okay, sir. So 6 to 7 or 7 to 8, sir?
Yes, better.
Morning 6 to 7 or 7 to 8, sir.